friend, now we'll see the next point, that is early high level languages. So in that we can say that three languages, that is Fortran, Algol 60 and COBOL. So these are the three most popular early high level languages, right? So out of these three, we can say that Fortran is the first widespread high level programming language, which is first language which is invented for the modularity purpose and compiles a program. So Fortran is mainly used to introduce the modularity. So modular programming is supported by Fortran language, and also Algol 60 is introduced to block structure and recursive procedures. So block structure and recursive structure or recursive procedures are supported in Algol 60. So we can say that both are used for solving numerical scientific problems. So mainly these languages are used for scientific research project, or in a research domain these languages are mostly used, again to solve the complex problem by using these languages is solved. So COBOL is introduced for business data processing purpose. So business data is nothing but we can say that the data which is related to its company, that is the employee data, marketing data, after that shares, production data. So these data is nothing but your business data, and to process these data is mainly used by using COBOL language. So COBOL language is used for business data processing, and it introduced file and data description, right? So this is about the early three high level languages, that is Fortran, Algol 60 and COBOL. So that Fortran is used for the modularity, again Algol is used for block structure and recursive procedures, and COBOL is used for business data processing. So again we can say that there are certain principles based on which the programming languages work. So for particular set of protocols or particular principles that should be followed by every programming language to achieve the reliability or maintainability. So what are the principles that every programming language should follow, or we can say various facilities which are provided by the programming languages are: first one, the programming language should be the simple. So how we can define the any programming language is simple? Simple is nothing but it should follow particular structure, and if it has a particular structure, then any program can be designed by using this programming language. So again, next one is syntax and semantics, semantic elements, program organization, program data and algorithms, and external environment. So we will see each one in depth. So these are the main various facilities provided by any programming languages. So first one is the simple program. So simple program, how we can define the program is a simple program. So it has the structure. If any program or any language, it has a particular structure, then we can say that it is the simple program. So consider a language, any C, C++, Java. So this has the particular structure or programming structure. So we can say that these languages are a simple programming language. So see, structure is nothing but again programming structure is divided into the three parts: structure, environment and computation part. So first one is structure is nothing but all library files and header files. See, hash, include, iostream, using namespace. So these comes under the structure part of programming language, that is all library files and headers. Second part is environment. Environment is nothing but declaration of variable and functions. So example, int abc or hide display function. So declaration of variable and function, which is comes under environment part. And computation part is nothing but main method body or another user defined function body. This is nothing but computation part or actual semantic part of your program is nothing but computation part. So this is the predefined structure of programming language. So we can say that because of this structure, programming language is simple, or it is easy to design the any problem statement. Now next one is syntax and semantic. So how we can define the syntax and semantic? Validation of any program is determined by syntax and semantic. So you can consider any program. So for that particular program, validation of program is determined by using syntax and semantic. So how we can define the syntax? So syntax is represent the structure of your program, that is the collection of rules of languages. So in that structure we can say that example is expression, statement, semicolon, opening brace, closing brace, etc. So it is used to define the structure or declare the structure or statement. So it is nothing but syntax. It so semantic rule, how semantic rule is nothing but it tell us the how to build meaningful expression, statement and functions. If even if the program or structure is synthetically correct, but semantically it should be or it will be wrong. So for example, 10 divided by 0. So 10 divided by 0, if syntax is correct, because it is 10 is integer, again divide is it is the operator, and 0 is again we can say that integer. So syntax is correct, but semantically it will give the exception. So we can say that it still the how meaningful expression it should be. So expression, statement, functions, these are comes under the semantic rules. For example, int c and float a b. So c is equal to a plus b. So this syntax is correct because it gives the semicolon, it represents the end of the line. But it is expected that a and b are float, so result should be stored in the float type, but it is stored in the integer type. So it is semantically wrong. So we can say that if the program is synthetically correct, it is always not that key, it is semantically also correct. So we can say that syntax rules are straightforward and simple to understand. So syntax, we can easily understand the syntax mistake or syntax error also we can identify. But whereas the semantic rules are complex and closely associated with the logic of the program. So your semantic is closely associated with the logic, or your we can say that main logic of your program, right? So next one we can say that semantic elements. So what are the semantic elements? Various elements that contribute in the formation of meaningful code, right? So meaningful code is formed by using the various elements. So for forming the meaningful code, we are using variable, value and references and expression. So by using these three elements, we can form the meaningful code, right? So variable, it is again variable. Various properties of variable are variable, example int x, it is the variable of integer type. So these again use for forming of meaningful code. So it has different properties, scope, type and its lifetime. Scope means it is whether it is global or it is local. Type is nothing but whether it is integer type, float type, character type, and its lifetime of the variable. Right, if suppose any variable which is used in the function, then its lifetime is during the execution of the function. If when the function is executed, then the memory which is allocated to the variable, it also erases. So we can say that these are the three properties of the variable: scope, type and its lifetime. Next one is value and reference. So value and reference we can see by using example, x is equal to 10 and y is equal to x, means assigning of the x to the y is nothing but value 10 is assigned to the y, and then x is equal to 10 and y is equal to ampersand x. So in that first, x is assigned to y, means value is assigned to the another variable, and in second, part, the reference of x is assigned to the y. Okay, this is nothing but value, assigned by value and assign reference. And last one is the expression. So expression is nothing but syntactic structure. That is, example, c is equal to a plus b. Again, these expressions play important role for forming of the meaningful code. So these three elements are used for forming of the meaningful code, that is variable, value and reference, and third one is expression. So next one is program organization. So organization, the name itself indicates that the program is organized into the different modules according to the its logic. So same features, modules are organized in the single unit, that is, we can say that module. So organizing this entire code into the different module, and this module can be stored in the separate file. Right? Suppose you can consider the one project of the login page, login and register to the particular system. So login module is separate, registration module is separate. So whatever the function which is related to that login is stored in the this module, and whatever the functions or whatever the classes which are required for the registration module are stored in the separate module, and these modules are stored in the separate file. So what is the advantages of doing this is, first one, the separate file can be developed by different programmer. Means suppose one developer is working on the login module and another developer can be work on registration module. Means parallelly they can be developed two modules. Next one is, specific modules are easy to maintain. So without modifying the whole project, the specific module, if there is the error or there is some changes in particular module, then that specific module will be easily modify or maintain. So third advantage is, any changes can be done in individual module. As we say, any changes can be done in individual module because the different modules are stored in according to the different category. So anyone can be changed that single standalone module. And last one is, the finding bugs and correcting them is easy and less complex because they are isolated modules. So it will be easy to modify particular module, and it is easy for finding the bug. And lastly, these isolated module will be merged into the single module, and this single module is nothing but your final project or final software. And next one is program data and algorithms. So these features of the programming language is very useful for designing the problem. Suppose any problem statement is given by user, so this statement is, before coding this statement, the programmer should write down the instructions in the form of the algorithm, that is sequence of instruction. So by using this sequence of instruction, it is easy to design or develop the statement or develop the problem statement, and it affects the execution efficiency of the program. So if the statements or problem statement is defined in well form, then it is very easy to design the any statement or to develop the any statement. So next one is external environment. So external environment is nothing but, we can say that any external files or external database or external header files are considered as external environment. So we can say that library files, iostream.h in C++ or in Java, we can say that any package, we can import any packages which is already built-in packages, we can import directly in your program. So these are considered as external environment, and these are the useful for developing the many modules. And it is, we can say that reuse of the code is achieved by using external environments.